all the violence and killing every day. It's time for us to stomp on Satan's face. He's defeated, God is on the rage. It's time for us to stand for our beliefs. Stand for something or fall for anything. If you know what I mean. Come on and clap your hands with me. It's time for us to search and see God's face. Let's obey, change our wicked ways. If we do, he'll bless us like he said. Now you're ready, come on and nod your head. Don't you know he's rich with house and land? Don't you remember Jesus is the man? Who heals the sick and set the captives free? Are you ready? Clap your hands with me.
A-N-T-A-A. Atlanta, Georgia, it's time for us to pray.
Listening to Gary Weiss Live Worldwide Podcast.
All right, what's going on, family? Family, happy Friday and welcome to Next Man Up with Dr. Paul Kelly right here on Positive Power. Good way side with Gary Weiss Live Worldwide Ministries. Can you feel the power? Can you feel it? Yes. What's up, Dr. Kelly?
We can feel the power, Jerry Roy.
Yes, sir.
How are you, sir, in the beautiful city of Charm City?
Oh, it's nice outside, sir. Feeling good. Just came back from the hospital. Had some good, delicious hospital food. I tell you, man, that lady could throw down in that hospital, that cafe. That's like my third meal, and they got the best dessert. Anyway, we're back, y'all, right here, Charm City, Maryland, better known as Baltimore. What's going on, Doc? How you feeling, Doc? You feeling good?
I'm feeling good, Doc. I'm feeling good, Dr. Gary Royce. When you mention the word hospitals, amen, of course, you know our viewers like to know, is the Batman all right, or are we visiting and lifting up prayers, sir?
Yeah, we visiting and lifting up prayers, man. You got to go visit family. You know, you got to keep them company. You know, they are, people like to have a little laughter. You know, Batman make you laugh. So we had to do our visiting. Of course, my wife was driving, and she drives slow when she's not going shopping. I feel like it took forever to get home. I'm like, which way is this? Wow. She's like, this is, I go different ways. It's like 100 ways we can go back home. Okay. No comment. Anyway, that's why Batman late.
Amen.
All right.
Hallelujah.
Well, we welcome the guys here on the Next Man Up panel. I know you're going to have a powerful podcast. And, of course, Brandon blessed us again with commentary for the show. And today's topic our advocate versus John.
Our advocate.
First John, second. What's that? Yeah.
That's it.
Yeah, so you got it, Doc. All
that's
right.
It, yeah.
All right, Doc, it's all yours.
Amen.
Batman's hallelujah. On me. All right, hallelujah. Amen. Let me let you guys
praise
out.
Praise God. Don't go too far, Batman.
Yeah, I'm right here.
Amen. Batman,
right here.
We just wanted, can you share with us just a few updates? You know, our listeners, amen, they look forward to updates, sir, on this powerful, powerful platform.
Yeah.
Amen. All over the world, sir. And they are here. They're waiting. I know this panel was waiting. Amen. Just a few updates.
Few updates.
Amen. I'm always excited.
Amen. Amen. Well, we got some great things happening. First off, we want to say welcome to Positive Power. We have a brand new show called Untold Chronicles with Jess Nia. That's right. Dr. Nia G has joined Positive Power. You actually catch her shows right now on demand. She'll be part of the morning drive time as soon as Batman renew his license to stream on Facebook. And also, of course, you can catch Stephen Turner, Elevation Radio 1, which has been a dynamite addition to Positive Power. He brings the shows that people don't want to talk about in the city. And he's going right after him. So that's happening right here on Positive Power. Pastor Stephen Turner. You catch his show on Elevation Radio 1, right here on Positive Power. And also coming to Positive Power is Miguel Profec Esparza. He's coming here with a brand new show, which is going to be a very powerful show. He's going to be bringing the people that nobody want to tell you anything about. These guys who are leaving the penal system rehabilitated and made their place in society as successful businessmen, ministers, pastors, you name it. So these are the guys he's going to be bringing to his program so they could tell you how good God has been to them, and they okay. They just want you to know they okay. Also, of course, the big news is Paula G. Listen to you all the time, Doc. I was going to call a doctor. Paula G will be having a big meet and greet event in Atlanta. We're going to be actually filming season 3 of My Journey with Paula G. This right airs on WATC Christian Public Television. Well, community television, because we got to pay to be on there. It airs on Sundays at 8 o'clock on WATC.TV. Or if you're in Atlanta, you can watch it on 57.2. And, of course, you catch it on all the Connect TV's networks. And also, you can catch it on Thursdays at 11:30 a.m. So she's going to be having a big event. It's going to be at the Black Box. I think it's called the Good Old Studio. I know she's listening to me right now. I'm messing it all up. I don't have my notes. But look for it on our page, y'all. We got promos running right now, and the event page is up. Just go ahead and search for Paula G, My Journey with Paula G. And a lot of information going to be floating around out there because we're looking for performers. But it's limited slots because we're only going to be filming for 3 hours. And like I said, we're only going to be filming for season 3. And we also have people that's going to be coming to Baltimore to be doing some studio work. So if you're an artist and you're looking for national television exposure, well, actually international, hit us up. And you've seen some of the work. You've seen Kent Osborne. You've seen Dr. Stephen Turner. I'm sorry, Pastor Stephen Turner. You saw Sherry Woodley, nominated, Tanya Dallas Lewis. You saw her. So these are some of the things that we're bringing to the network. And, you know, so people get a chance to know you. People don't buy from you if they don't know you. So think about that, artist. If you don't have a music video, you're not doing any television shows, you know, you're not airing on Facebook, how are people going to know where to buy your stuff? You know, just think about it. You know, Kirk Franklin didn't become Kirk Franklin sitting at home performing in front of his family. He was out there on Dr. Bobby Jones' platform, right? And look at him now. Y'all know Adam, just to name a few.
Absolutely.
Tosh and Cobbs, they're on YouTube. That's what you got to do. You got to invest some money in yourself. So we do have the opportunity. We also going to be working on a big television special real soon. So you got to connect with us. Big television special coming up real soon. It's going to be shot in a very nice theater that seats over 400 people. And so that's going to be happening real soon. So you got to get to know us. And also, Lakeisha Mosey going to be in Baltimore. That's right, filming the Lakeisha Mosey show at Anthony Avery's event on March 9th in Baltimore. So you want more information about that, he's offering vendoring and other opportunities. So hit up Anthony Avery on his Facebook page. Inbox him, find out how you be part of that. We will be conducting interviews. Like I said, it's going to be happening in Baltimore in Charm City, right downtown in Baltimore, around that North Avenue corridor. So that's happening March 9th. So we're going to be there with Lakeisha Mosey's show, shooting a segment for her show. So come on out and join us. Come meet Batman. And I think there's a whole bunch of stuff going on, so I'm not going to take up no more time. But that's the most important things that's going on right now. Amen. Thanks, Doc, for your time.
Amen. Thank you, Dr. Jerry Royce, a.k.a. Batman.
Amen.
And once again, we welcome Dr. Nia. Amen. Welcome to Positive Power. Amen. Also, Pastor Stephen Turner, Elevation Radio 1. And Also, one of our very own guest panelists right here, next man up, Miguel Perfect. We welcome each and every one of them, to this powerful show. Amen. Of course, not to mention, amen, most importantly, Mrs. Paula G, just as Dr. Jerry Royce has said, amen. Big meet and greet coming up, amen, for a powerful, powerful, powerful woman of God, amen, host of My Journey. She will also be celebrating her birthday. And
right.
Pastor's Time Ministry is one of her underwriters, and we're honored to be so, be one of her underwriters on that powerful show produced by the award-winning Jerry Royce Live.
Amen.
Praise God. And before we get to this panel, amen, I would like to thank everyone out there for all of those nice, those powerful and beautiful anointing birthday shout-outs.
Amen.
Mainly, amen, to my powerful, powerful, positive power family. All of you. Thank you for the personal calls, Jerry Royce, amen, the Empire actor, Dr. Charles Clark, praise God. Just personal phone calls, those means a lot. But most importantly, my beautiful wife and family, amen. We thank everyone out there for just celebrating. Had lots of fun, Jerry. Had lots
did.
Of fun. Like
yes,
that cool
sir.
Video, sir, you produced.
Amen. You know, anything for the
Hallelujah.
Doctor.
Hallelujah.
Anything for the doctor.
Hallelujah. It means a lot from my heart. We really love you guys. Amen. It's just a beautiful family. Amen. Amen. These gentlemen are waiting, doctor.
Yes,
let's
sir.
Bring them on. Roll call.
Yeah. You're going to have that roll call because you got some new additions here. We're going to bring on some new people from the CMG. I just want to give a shout out to CMG, Dwayne Culpepper. He got some young guys that's going to come on and be part. They weren't ready tonight. But we're going to have those guys come
Amen.
On. We got to get them prepared and, you know, groom them a little bit so they be ready for the next man up.
Mm-hmm.
All right. But you do have Minister John E. Ross. You got Denny. My man Denny's here. That's right. You know Denny and Mike Jenkins. And then you have, of course, we got Minister Eric Williams is here tonight. And Pastor Stephen Turner is in the house. So that's your panelists for tonight. Miguel sent his love. And he will be back real soon because he's getting ready for his big opening of his show for March. Amen.
Amen. Praise God. Well, without further ado, praise the Lord, everybody, and welcome to Next Man Up Summit right here on Jerry Royce Live. Before we get to this powerful panel, can y'all feel the power out there? Show us some love. Amen. Can y'all feel the power? Robot, show these men some love. Hallelujah.
Humble, young man, humble.
Amen. God is good.
Amen. Once again, robot, he be on it. Praise God. Once again, I am your host, moderator, amen, Dr. Paul Keller. Let's get to these group of men. Let's get to our powerful panel. Praise God. Come on in, Apostle John Ross. As a matter of fact, Apostle John Ross, just open us up in prayer, and we'll just go down the list. Denny Jenkins, Minister Eric Williams, amen, and Pastor Stephen Turner. Each one of you, just kind of introduce yourself to the nation. Let's open up in prayer first. Apostle John Ross, amen. Lift the nation up, sir.
Lord, we give you glory. We give you praise for this day. Lord, we thank you for keeping us this week. We thank you for blessing us to gather again for another Next Man Up Summit as we discuss your advocacy to us. Lord, we ask you to open up our minds, open up our
Hallelujah.
Spirits, open up our understanding, open us up, Lord, to receive from you. Lord, if we've done anything that have offended you, we ask you to forgive us, Lord. Lord, we ask you to send your anointing, send your power, and send your spirit. Lord, we ask you to saturate the radio airwaves, Lord, to those who are listening. Hallelujah. That lives will be changed and transformed by the power of the Holy Spirit and in the name of Jesus Christ. Lord, we ask you to crush every demonic interference and every demonic spirit that will try to cause confusion even in this summit. But Lord, we ask you to shift the atmosphere to you, to the open heaven over this Next Man Up Summit so that we can receive from you in Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen. Praise God. Apostle John Rawls, let's talk to the Lord. Take a few minutes, sir. Beautiful prayer. And just share with the nation, amen, a couple of minutes. We can go right down the panel. We're going to open up this powerful program, an advocate. Jesus Christ is our advocate. Amen. Tell us a few minutes, who is Apostle John Rawls?
I am very excited at this time because we just recorded the Let's Talk to the Lord 100th episode celebration that will air this coming Tuesday, the 26th at 7 p.m. Central Time on Kingdom Influencers Broadcast.com. All episodes can be downloaded and shared and listened to on iHeartRadio speaker, Facebook, YouTube, and PositivePower.org as we celebrate 100 episodes for the Let's Talk to the Lord Gospel Radio Talk Show. And we are narrowing down to the last week to still cast your vote for my latest EP, Remember Now Thy Creator, that has been nominated for 5 Rhythm of the Gospel Awards in categories 21, 22, 24, 39, and 56. You can still support me by going to www.therhythmofgospelawards.com to cast your vote before March the 1st.
Praise the Lord. Thank you very much, Apostle Johnny Rawls. Amen. A regular here and a very, very special young man of God. Amen. He loves his students. He loves transporting them. Just real life ministry. Praise God. And he often gives us an update on his students as well. Praise God. Thank you, Apostle John Rawls, for that warm, warm introduction of yourself. Praise God. And your ministry. And congratulations again on your 100th show. Praise God.
Thank you.
Artist Dennis Jenkins, my man, praise God. I had a pleasure just speaking with this gentleman, praise God. Introduce yourself, sir, amen, and we'll go right to minister, I call him preacher man, Eric Williams, amen, and then we'll go to Pastor Stephen. We're going to start this powerful show. Artist Dennis Jenkins, amen, take a chance, take a few moments to introduce yourself, sir.
Amen. How you doing, Dr. Kelly?
Hallelujah. Wonderful, sir. Praise God. Talk to us, sir, for a few minutes.
Well, it's a blessing to be here. I believe Jerry has me pitch-hitting for Miguel, you know.
All right.
It's a pleasure to be here because, like I said, we have had a conversation, and you are truly a man of God, and it is truly...
Thank you, sir.
I appreciate having met you.
Bless you.
Look forward to our endeavors together. But again, I am Denny Jenkins. I am co-founder of Spirit to Spirit Message Music Communications Incorporated. We are a 501c3 nonprofit organization, home-based at this point, trying to do as much good as we can for those who are less fortunate in so many areas. I heard Jerry speak about people, some folks just... Re-entering a society from being locked up. I know about that situation, and I know how hard that can be. So I commend the gentleman for his work, and we are doing some of that same type of work also. I am also an independent artist. I wouldn't say gospel artist because what we do is not really gospel, but there is faith-based music. It's called Message Music. You can find out whatever it is you need to know about our organization at our website, www.spiritmessagemusic.com. There's so much going on in my life and so much I can talk about. I'll just sit back, listen, and input when I can input.
Hallelujah. Amen. Thank you, sir. Spirit to Spirit, we'd like to give a shout out to that powerful nonprofit organization. God, who are we looking forward to just getting to know more about? Thank you, Minister, artist Dennis Jenkins. We love your music, bro. I'll be checking you out. I see you out there. Amen.
Yes,
praise God. Continue to do what you're doing, sir. Minister, preacher man, Eric Williams. talk to the nation, sir. Introduce yourself, sir.
I'm Eric Williams. God has really gifted me with a lot of gifts, and I'm very thankful, very grateful, very humble. You know, I always have an ear to listen. I have a program entitled Guns Down, Power Up. And what I do, I'm a community activist as well. I go into the community. I set up my chess program. I like to inspire youth. I also go into the school system. With that being said, I'm a motivational speaker as well. I was 18 years old at one point on the fourth grade level in special education, but to God be the glory. I graduated with a high school diploma, and I know the power of God and what he can do with our minds when we give them to him. When we give God our mind, he can do great things. So I just continue on sharing the word of God and inspiration and motivating people to do the right things.
Absolutely. We'd like to give a shout-out out there, sir, to your activist group, Guns Down, Power Up. Amen. I like that. Empowering of the mind. Amen. Ladies and gentlemen, Minister Eric Williams, activist, thank you for being with us tonight. Pastor Stephen Turner, praise God. Introduce yourself, Pastor, to the nation, and we'll get right to this powerful platform, sir.
All right, God bless you. To all the great
God
gentlemen
bless
there.
You, sir.
And to Pastor Ross, so, congratulations. And to the preacher machine, Eric Williams.
Okay. I'll be the glory.
God bless you. Let me see here. Organist, 53 years. Minister of Music, music activist, and the owner of Praise Unlimited Ministries, providing one call organist and concert, community concerts since 1994, and Stephen Turner Ministries, which I do Christian acting, and also I've got two books coming out on March 23rd at a double book signing party here in Baltimore. So it's on Facebook, and husband, grandfather, just an old man who loves to hang around young people so I can maintain my son. And that's all I'm going to say now.
Amen. Hallelujah, 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 praise God. Well, we certainly thank Pastor Stephen Turner, amen, for being with us tonight. I've had an honor and pleasure to speaking with this gentleman and also being on his powerful radio show, Elevation One. Such an inspiring man of God. If you're not tuned to laughing, when you get around him and you lift up the name of God, just get ready to laugh. Have a little laughter, because God certainly has a sense of humor. Praise God. Mr. Jerry Royce, one of his colleagues, amen, certainly edify Pastor Stephen Turner. I think they're classmates, as a matter of fact. Praise God. Amen. Is that right, Pastor?
I was smarter than he was in school.
Sorry about that, bad man. I ain't mean that.
Right. I'm going to let him slide on that one.
I told you they funny, man. They funny. Hallelujah. Amen. Pastor John Ross, thank you for the prayer. Pastor Stephen Turner, we're going to ask you to close us out in prayer. Gentlemen, let's start this powerful platform. And we thank you all for just tuning in. We thank the nation. Amen. Gentlemen, can y'all feel the power?
Yes,
sir. Feel the power.
Hallelujah. We can feel the power. Once again, I am your host, moderator, Dr. Paul Kelly. We do have a very special group of men, anointed spiritual leaders on the panel tonight. Amen. They've already introduced themselves. Amen. Our powerful discussion for tonight, gentlemen, is our advocate. Each and one of you gentlemen are spiritual men of God, and y'all should be prepared for this. Amen. I always like to come at a different twist. Gentlemen, y'all know Dr. Kelly, transparency. Amen. Jesus is our spiritual advocate. 1 John 2, amen. And that second part of that verse, that first verse, part B. And we're also going to look at the second verse, just those two verses. And we'd like to give a shout out to Mr. Brandon Sampson of LUSU Apparel for his powerful inspirational devotional commentary that he's contributed to this panel. Praise God. Let's dive into this. Praise God. Let's just go and get to this powerful topic. Amen. Jesus works on our behalf as an advocate. Amen, gentlemen.
Amen.
And he talks on our behalf. Amen, Pastor Turner. Amen. And Brother Eric Williams, amen, he also provide, and you speak of this a lot, Mr. Eric Williams, when you open up. He talks about love. You talk about love. John Ross talks about love. Artist Dennis Jenkins, Spirit to Spirit, amen. We all talk about provisions. That's the angle. That's what we're going to talk about. There is a provision made on our behalf, amen, and that's Jesus. When trouble rises, if y'all allow me, give me about 2 minutes and we'll set this up. I just like to open it up strong so you gentlemen can just come on in and just take this thing over. Amen. I'm going to pass this mic to the next man up. Amen. Apostle John Ross. Amen. Because this is a hot mic tonight. Hot mics. Amen. Amen. There is a provision made on our behalf when trouble rises, when storm comes, Apostle John Ross. And Jesus is an advocate, an almighty, omnipresent, omnipotent, omnipotent, omniscient, powerful, spiritual, I like to say a defense lawyer. Come on, somebody. Amen. He's a spiritual advocate. Jesus is. And Jesus is our defender, even when we sin. Amen. Brother Denny Jenkins, Jesus is our defender. Amen. And he is not shocked by our own human behavior. So he ain't surprised by our human behavior because he created us. So he is seen, amen. He is seen in this chapter of 1 John. He is seen, he's seen it all in advance because he already knows what we're going to do even before we think. Why? Because, again, I said he created us. Now watch this, gentlemen. I like Brandon. I like Brandon Sampson's talking points here. Praise God, because it's real. Amen. But the professor, y'all know, I have to come back and bring this thing on a practical theological explanation. Brandon, basically, I like what he's saying. He didn't forgive us at one time or later, and then look back and say, okay, here they go again. God doesn't work that way. Go ahead, Brandon. I wish he could come on and speak with us. Amen. Even after Adam and Eve sinned, he already had a spiritual advocate ready to give on our behalf. And that is his only begotten son, Jesus Christ. We get ready to dive into this. Most important, his forgiveness is available for us now. And I'm talking to this nation. I'm talking to really those who are out there who haven't given their self to Christ, given their hearts to Christ. And I'm also speaking to those gentlemen. We're going to be speaking to some people out there who feel like they have been psychologically used after they have been saved by Satan. Y'all catch that? Did y'all catch all that?
Mm-hmm.
Psychologically making them feel, people making them feel guilty. They've already been forgiven, amen, for those who have asked God. So we may think that our sin, amen, we may think sometimes people think that after they have been forgiven, they're no longer a part of God's family, but they are. Once you say, God, please come into my life. God, thank you for forgiving me of my sins. I want you to live in my heart. I believe that you are the risen Christ, and I believe that you got up from the dead. God, I want you to live in my life. Forgive me of my sins, oh God. So in other words, he went on to be the ultimate, Christ went on to be the ultimate measure to make us able to stand in the face of his holy righteousness through his only begotten son, Jesus. In other words, get ready, gentlemen, to make this a little practical. Let's look at this thing in a court scene, a court system. Amen. A human defense lawyer argues for the innocence of his clients. Is that right, gentlemen?
That's right.
Yes, sir.
But our spiritual advocate, Jesus Christ, he admits, in other words, he goes to God for us, and he pleads on our behalf, amen, as the one who has made an atoning sacrifice for our sinful guilt, amen. So here in this theological and practical, amen, text here in John, amen, we must also remember this. Brother Eric Williams, I know you're going to eat this one up. Amen. In this theological practical reason why Jesus is our spiritual advocate, let's look back to Revelation, or I should say, let's look forward to Revelations 12 and 10 specifically. And I would ask our producer to post this, because I really want those out there to remember. And Revelations 12 and 10 reminds us, as John was on the Isle of Patmos, his vision, he was in heaven, and he said, "Then I heard a loud voice in heaven." This is Revelations 12 and 10. "Now salvation and strength and the kingdom of our God and the power of his Christ has come. For the accuser," now watch this, "for the accuser of our brother," which is Satan, "who has accused them before our God day and night, has been cast down." In other words, Lucifer, he has no power over God's people. He has no power. No power at all. So then, the reminder to the believers, we need to distinguish and rightly know the difference between the condemning accusations of Satan and the loving conviction of God's Holy Spirit. Can somebody say amen on that?
Amen.
Hallelujah. So in that second verse, we see the word propitiation, and this is just for our listeners and for those who have just given themselves to Christ. If you allow, amen, me to enlighten the people on this one word, on this propitiation, in the Greek, this has the idea of presenting a gift to God. That's a small g now. This is from the Greek perspective. Amen. As to turn away the displeasure of God. So, in other words, the Greeks thought of this propitiation as a sense of man's essentially bribing the gods into doing favors for them. However, for our nation and those new believers and those who have already accepted Christ, however, theologically speaking, the Christian's idea of propitiation, God himself presents himself in Jesus Christ, his son, so that which would turn away his righteousness wrath against our sin. In other words, he pleads on our case for our Father God. Gentlemen, let's go. We're talking about atonement. We're talking about what Moses taught back in Leviticus 16 and 34. Amen. When the sin of all Israel was atoned for every year at the Day of Atonement, yet not all of Israel was saved. The words, amen, but also the whole world. Gentlemen, let's go ahead and dive into this. Minister John Ross, amen, we're talking about an advocate. There's a lot just in these two verses. Amen. And John's words in this powerful text teaches the difference between light and darkness, the new commandments and the old commandments. I should say the Old Testament. He teaches the difference between loving the Father and God and those who love the world. John teaches the difference between truth and lies. Amen. Minister Dennis Jenkins. Amen. He also teaches the difference between love and hatred, true teaching and false teaching, and between love and fear and having life and not having life. And he was writing to all the believers of all ages. Let's just go ahead and look at this first verse. First John, amen, 2. Amen. Let's just look at it. He had experiences in the beginning. John, I want you to just go ahead, Mr. John Ross, in your own way, share with us when you gleaned into this text what you see here as God as an advocate. Just talk to the audience in your own way, sir.
Kingdom, our advocate, Christ Jesus, our advocate, meaning the one who will intercede for us with God the Father, because he became the atoning sacrifice for our sins. But what I want to add is, but how can he advocate without us first repenting and accepting his sacrifice, meaning coming into relationship, fellowship, and union with Christ Jesus? Understand, before this advocacy can be made valid in our lives, we must first accept Christ Jesus as Savior and Lord. Next, we must understand what it means to truly repent and what the fruits of repentance are for those of us who have been redeemed. The first fruit of repentance is a changed heart from carnal attitudes of hostility toward God and rebellion against God's law to the opposite attitude of love, submission, obedience, and worship of God and reliance on Him. True repentance is an about face in our attitude and actions and in the intent to the way of God's righteousness. True kingdom repentance is a summons to a personal, voluntary, and ultimate unconditional surrender of our will, of our fleshly-driven demonic ways of thinking and acting with a truly willingness to change, to stop. With true regret, we make a 180-degree turn the opposite way from those sinful actions for conviction, repentance, healing, restoration, and then grafting back into the body of Christ by God, the Holy Spirit.
Praise God. Praise God, John. Amen. Thank you. Thank you, Minister John Ross. That was beautifully well stated. First of all, he basically said, how can Jesus act as an advocate unless we give him our lives? That was the opening. That was the opening statement. You're absolutely. And then, John, I like that because you use the analogy of fruits. Amen. Repentance. Amen. And about faith in our attitude. Wow. Yeah. Wow. That's deep, Doc. Amen. Denny Jenkins. Amen. Artist Dennis Jenkins. I want you to, from spirit to spirit, thank you and welcome to the show. I want you to dig right in here. Amen. Why is it, Mr. Jenkins, is it important as spiritual leaders not to make, as John said, once we accept Christ, once those believers come into the ark of safety, there's a lot that's going on in our churches nowadays and in our homes and in our ministries. Why is it important as spiritual leaders? I want y'all to catch that. And our viewers out there on Facebook, I want y'all to just give us some of y'all answers and feedback, amen. Why is it important as spiritual leaders not to make those who have already accepted Christ, not to continue to feel as though they are still living a bad life? As John has said it so well, amen, we first, amen, have to give God our lives. Now that we have done that, Mr. Jenkins, why is it so important as spiritual leaders not to continue to make those, amen, who have already accepted Christ, not to continue to feel as though that they are still living a bad life, or to make them psychologically, here it is, feel guilty for something they have been forgiven for already? In other words, Batman gonna like this. You can't be tried for a case that is no longer on the docket. Woo! Go ahead, Brother Jenkins.
Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. See, well, for me, I was raised in the church. And yes, as sir. I grew older and came to some understanding of the word, I still suffered church hurt because the leaders of the church were basically talking over my head. I mean, it's like they weren't talking to me. You know, if I didn't have the understanding that they had, then it was like that was a waste of time.
Come on.
I had to go back to my teaching from home. My mother made it real simple for me. She said, you first have to believe. If you don't believe, you have nothing coming. I mean, she made it just that simple. She said, first you have to believe. And the word is said, he who believes in me shall not perish, shall not die, but have everlasting life. That was simple for me. She didn't tell me I had to stop smoking. She didn't tell me that I had to stop chasing women. She didn't tell me not to do drugs. She told me to live. God had purpose on my life. And the more that I experienced, I would, and pray, because it was important to pray for the power to understand his word, for the power to realize that in my own power, I could do nothing. Mm-hmm. I just give you a good example. I don't want to go on and on, but a good example. It's like when I wanted to get off of drugs and I first went and to get some help. The first time it didn't take. Sure, we had doctors that understood the sickness, but it's the spiritual that was not being worked on.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Even in the rooms, they would say a power, some power greater than self. But if you had no relationship with God, no understanding of what Jesus sacrificed, that we might have life and have life more abundantly, it still was all in vain. I had to surrender. I had to come to the lowest point in my life and realize, even though I thought I was at my lowest, the trap door could open up on that. If I did not surrender and say, Lord, please, please do for me what I cannot do for myself. This is your life.
Yes, sir.
I am just a vessel. Have your way with me. But again, you have to experience the hurt. You have to experience the pain.
Yes,
if
sir.
Everything goes good in your life, who can you thank for that?
Ooh.
You would think it was all done in your own power.
Yes,
we must
coming
fall down so that we can get up. But we can't get up if we don't believe in Christ. That there was somebody, like you said, an advocate, someone who was stating your case for
you. There you go.
Because you were less than perfect. The human condition is all about sin. It's rooted in sin.
Mm-hmm.
But there is Jesus to state your case for you. But you got to believe. If you don't believe it, you can't receive it.
All right. All right. If you don't believe, you can't receive it. There you have it, Mr. Jenkins, Denny Jenkins, amen, spirit to spirit. Ladies and gentlemen, if you're just tuning in, we're discussing a powerful, powerful dialogue here, amen, coming out of 1 John 2, amen, 1 and 2, amen, Jesus as our advocate. And we are entertaining the observation of why is it important as spiritual believers not to make those who have already accepted Christ not to continue to feel as though they are still living a bad life. Or to continue to make them psychologically feel guilty for something they have been forgiven for already through God. Amen. In other words, you can't be tried for a case that's no longer on this docket, this worldly docket. Amen. In other words, I like what Mr. Jenkins has said. Amen. He suffered church hurt. I just need somebody out there to start talking tonight. Amen. On the power of God, how God instilled in you that I am somebody. I have been saved. Jesus fights on my behalf. Amen. In other words, Batman said, I feel the power. That is a powerful word. If you just start saying it every day, I feel the power of God, you would begin to feel change. Mr. Jenkins, thank you for those powerful words. Amen. Minister Eric Williams, guns down, power up, and powering of the mind. Talk to us. Just take this and run with it. Don't be afraid to ask Jesus to fight on your behalf or plead your case. Preach to us, preacher.
Yes, sir. I'd like to thank God for this opportunity. Let me share something with you people out there that are listening, and I guarantee you this is really going to bless you. You need to realize man don't have a heaven or a hell to put you in. I'm going to say that again. Man do not have a heaven or a hell to put you in. But we have to stay within the guidelines. We have to stay within the will. We have to stay within the love. We have to stay within the grace and mercy, because it's new every morning. God give us a fresh dose of grace and mercy. Every morning is renewed, it's fresh. Now we look at Adam. I want to look at Adam. Adam failed. And in him falling, what happened? He realized he was naked. What happened? He began to be shamed. What happened? He began to try to make his own covering. And that is what's happening with a lot of our brothers and sisters in Christ. They begin to try to make their own coverings. They begin to try to become, if I do this, if I do that, if I do this.
and they become the word called self-righteousness to X out everything that Christ have done, because we think that we can do it within our own strength when he is our advocate. It ain't that we're so good. It ain't that we're so perfect. It's because of the grace and the love of God that we live and move and that we have our being. He's constantly reminding God of the blood. Just like when the death angel came and when the children of Israel were in Egypt and Pharaoh didn't want to let them go. They had to put the blood on the doorposts. They had to put the blood on the doorposts. And when the death angel came, it was passed. The same way Christ's blood was shed for us. The same way when God look at us, he don't see us. He see his son in us. He see the blood of Jesus that covers us, that keeps us. We looked at Genesis, and it ain't going to be long. Genesis chapter 3, verse 21. And to Adam also and to his wife did the Lord God make coats of skins and clothe them. You see, at first they were trying to hide with some bushes, trying to make their own covering. God had to kill something. Some blood had to be shed. Even in Genesis, some blood had to be shed. Some animal skin, God had to use that to cover them. We can't cover ourselves. We have to allow God to cover us. And we have to remember that we can't go so too far. We can't go too far to repent. And God's arms is not there to reach and guide us and lead us back to his love.
Praise God. Hallelujah, minister. Preacher man Eric Williams, gun down, power up, amen. You share some powerful stuff that you with the nation, hallelujah. And that once we give ourselves to Christ, sir, God covers us. And I love your analogy of Adam and Eve, how they covered themselves. Who told you you were naked, amen? As a matter of fact, Adam, where art thou? Praise God. Mm. And that is powerful in the Old Testament. Amen. The sheep, for the most part, die for men. Amen. That blood. And that is powerful analogy. So in the New Testament, Christ died for the sheep. Did they catch that, Brother Williams? Amen. Did the nation, did they catch that? Amen. In the Old Testament, the sheep died. Amen. For us. Amen. The remission of blood. And that's what I got out of your analogy. But in the New Testament, amen, Jesus, which is the Lamb of God, he died for us. So he covers us. Oh, good
yes,
God.
Sir.
Don't be afraid. Thank you, Minister Eric Williams. Don't be afraid, nation, to ask Jesus to fight on your behalf. That's what these gentlemen are saying. Amen. To plead your case. Why? Because Satan is angry. And now that you are in the safety of Jesus, he's already on our case. In Romans 8:33 reminds us, and I'm getting ready to go into this, our next question, amen, our next dialogue, Pastor Turner. I'm setting this up for you, Pastor. Romans 8:33, Pastor Turner, it reminds us, Romans 8:33, I want the nation, if you're out there in your spare time, go to these chapters and study them. It reminds us, who shall bring charge? This is Paul now. Who shall bring charge against God's elect? Just imagine yourself in a court of law, and Jesus come down from heaven and said, who shall bring a charge against Apostle John Ross, against Dennis Jenkins, amen, against Minister Eric Williams, against Pastor Turner, Jerry Royce, against Dr. Paul Kelly, against Lakeisha Mosley, amen, Paula G., who shall bring a charge against Dr. Charles Clark or Terrell, amen. Who shall bring a charge against these people, these men and women of God, Clinton Terry, amen, Cleon Hardy, Cedric Rashad, who shall bring a charge against Sean Ray Price? Or somebody gonna shout today. Who shall bring a charge against Paula G? That's what Romans 8:33 is saying. Who shall bring a charge against God's elect? Pastor Turner, I need you to help somebody out there. The second part of this powerful verse over in Romans 8:33 says, it is God who justifies. Amen. Pastor Turner, just as the book of John that we're out of the book of Romans is more than just a theological explanation of God's saving grace. Pastor Turner, my brother, and I've spoken with you, it's a love letter of confidence in addressing us and assuring us, just as Minister Williams said, amen, in assuring us of God's power and his saving grace. In other words, Jesus paid the sin, Pastor Turner. He paid the sin and penalty of our sin. And once we confess our sin and accept Christ as our personal Savior and invite him, as John Ross said, into our lives, amen, first, live in our soul, then he protects us from evildoers. Pastor Turner, share with someone out there who may not be sure that they have been forgiven of their sin. They, you know, some folk just ain't sure. Amen. Or they're being constant accused by evildoers of their past. Pastor Turner, take a few minutes to remind them of the power of God and his protection. Amen. Nation out there, help us out. Come on, somebody. Just y'all have church with us tonight. Pastor Turner, the mic is yours. A hot mic, sir.
All right. Well, I can just say that I wasn't always a pastor. I was running from my calling, and I was a Baltimore City police officer for about 5 years, and I began to handle the case and tell the truth, and as we understand from the news coverage about our fair city and the police department, they don't always tell the truth. So they decided to, when I was subpoenaed, in a three-person murder case, I told the truth, and they came outside in the hallway, and the state's attorney said, "You're going to be charged with perjury." And I said, "Charged with perjury? I've never done anything in my entire life. Why would I wait now to be a police officer to get in this type of trouble?" And so they began the department, the homicide detectives, they basically did everything they could to me. They demoted me. They took my gun like they do on TV. They sent me down to a room, a quartermaster, where I can look at uniforms and tear up, you know, cupboards, and they would throw uniforms around and throw brooms at me and try to get me to quit. Psychological torture. This lasted for over a year. We went to different courts and cases and judges. And one time my defense attorney was so upset with the judge that the judge yelled at him. I thought for a second that he was going to get locked up, and I said, "Well, if you get locked up, who's going to defend me?" So I was sitting in the hallway by myself, and I started feeling kind of my feelings, because I've said all these churches I've played for, these places I've been, I've got no pastor to come down to help me. So I'm sitting here by myself, but I realized I'm not alone. I had the Bible with me, and the homicide detectives would come in the hallway and say, "You got that piece of blah, blah, blah. You're going to need more than that, because we're going to put you away for 10 years in federal prison."
Wow.
And so I was shunned, fired from my job as a musician. No one wanted to talk to me. I was just, I had to move from, I was shacking with somebody. Just went living right. And that was the thing. I had to go to an efficiency apartment. I had the investigators spying me, watching me. And so I looked out the window, they're looking at me in the car. And at some point, I just wondered, where is God now? I'm out here by myself. I feel alone and destitute. I'm so distraught. I didn't even want my mama to know what was going on. And so, to make a long story short, I was accused of perjury, which is a death sentence to the career of a law enforcement officer. And I've not been able to live. When they finally got me out, they said, "You'll never work in law enforcement again," which means economically they were trying to say, "You'll never work again." They went into the health career. We understand you was out with perjury. They went into churches, and pastors would not hire me to play. Oh, my God. But I'm just saying, 20-some years later, they still follow me, still eavesdropping on my phone, still harassing me. Yet, good God Almighty, I've never seen the righteous forsaken, nor the seed begging for bread. And so I just want to say to somebody that there are different levels of redemption. The defense attorney is always looking for a complete case where it's in the best interest of his client. So you may get a stet, which is an inactive docket, for 1 year. That's the devil
will mean to that. He may actually get a null prize or refuse to prosecute because they don't have enough evidence.
Come on.
Or he may give you a PBJ where we have enough evidence to prosecute you, but we're going to give you, and that's what I got. I got a PBJ, and they tried to, watch me and all that, but God delivered me. And so I haven't missed a meal. Good God Almighty. And so I lost my first wife. So I determined I would not lose my second. And although I've not been able to get 9-to-5 jobs, God is still taking care of me. And God will still take care of you, whoever you are. That's what I'm trying to say. God, even if you haven't hired him,
come on,
will still advocate for you. This I know. This I've seen with my own eyes. And so I just want to encourage somebody out there that you never know what you've been through. Most pastors and bishops and apostles and all four wouldn't be so stuffy. They wouldn't tell the truth. They know that they've come through hell and high water. They haven't dotted every I and crossed every T. And some people need to hear that so they can be encouraged.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Pastor. Thank you, Pastor. Mm-hmm. Amen. Thank you, mm-hmm. Pastor Gene Turner. The analogy of being falsely accused during his career as a police officer. Amen. After all said and done, no evidence. No evidence. God delivered you. Praise God. You're just tuning in on this powerful episode. Our advocate, Jesus, is our spiritual advocate. John's words is powerful, again, nation, in that he teaches the difference between light and darkness. Amen, somebody? Amen.
Amen.
The new commandments and the old commandments, I said that earlier. He teaches the difference between loving the Father of God and those who love the world. He teaches the difference between truth and lies, eternal life and eternal death. He teaches the difference between love and hatred. He teaches the difference between true teaching and false teaching. I want to hear from our producer. Amen. I know he's in the background, but this brother, Dr. Jerry Royce, always brings some profound words, especially when it comes to an advocate. Amen. We talk about a lot of his journey on his job, and the most empowering thing that I hear from him in the spirit that God has manifested, amen, when we talk about that, amen, is how God rescues him. And in his own way, ladies and gentlemen, as I set him up, amen, to share with you, Dr. Jerry Royce, amen, you're talking about a jewel, amen, who has visions beyond visions. And I know when he speaks to me, I listen. I actually pick up my pen and I write down, amen, things that I should know and come back to. But when he talks about God intervening with him, I'm going to let him say it for itself, amen. Ladies and gentlemen, amen, without further ado, amen, award-winning producer, amen, CEO, Mr. Jerry Royce, speak to the nation on God being your advocate, sir.
Amen. What's up, brothers?
Hallelujah.
I'm going to tell you, listening to Pastor Steve, I know what Baltimore is like, but I'm not going to go there. But I'm going to tell you this. When that piece about Jesus being your advocate, you know how sometimes you think you're alone, just like what Steve said, he was sitting out that hallway. Sometime,
yes, sir.
God will send Jesus and he will whisper to you something that's going to get you out your situation. Now, the funny thing about God, he may have whispered this to you years ago, before the situation happened. And then suddenly you may retain it. And then that's when you start feeling that comfort, because he told you probably years ago that this was going to happen. This was going to be your situation, but it was going to be okay. But sometimes we don't listen and we take a blind eye to things. You've seen it coming. But, when you lose your faith, that's when you're in trouble. When you lose the faith. And then you think about those of you that are fathers. When your baby girl or your baby boy asks you for something, I don't care if you got a nickel in your pocket, you're going to find a way to make them happy, because they asked you for that. They didn't just show it to you or hinted it around. they ask you for. And sometimes we forget to ask our advocate, Jesus Christ, what we want. Sometimes we think it's too far-fetched. And I'm going to tell you, and Dr. Keller, he listens to me all the time. And I'm not even going to share it on this air because I don't want people to think the Batman's sitting here bragging. But if you know anything about the Batman, and Steven knew me, he you know, of course he came on here and told you he was smarter than me. But he but he's, you know, and I know, and Denny has met me. He, you know, man, all I can say is, when Brandon wrote that piece, man, he, and it's going to be more to it, because I think, and this is something that was really deep that came to me this week. I saw three documentaries. Okay, and this is God whispering to us, you know, the Stephen, that it's going to be okay, and you're okay right now. Of course, a lot of it right now is on you, right? And Denny, we all know it's on us, yeah, right now, you know, when it comes to our health, because all three of us in the same situation.
Amen.
But it's just time for us to do something about it. But I'm going to tell you, I saw three documentaries. One was about Sam Cooke. The other one was on Teddy Pendergrass. And the other one was a talk show with the brother Maverick, who's LeBron James' best friend, who has a talk show. He was interviewing Magic Johnson. And Magic Johnson, this is on Magic Johnson's TV station, Aspire. And, man, I was so motivated by all three documents, even though Sam Cooke did not become the iconic entrepreneur that he was designed to be. And people don't know that Sam Cooke and Teddy Pendergrass was very powerful. And you check out the documentary, y'all see what I mean. A lot of people don't know their history. They just think they were good singers. They were more than performers. A lot of that was important to where we are right now and where we're trying to go as God's children, his people. God is whispering to us and he's showing us things. That's all I got to say. Dr. Advocate is speaking to us. He's speaking to us. You just got to listen. And don't be scared. That's all I got to say.
Hallelujah. Don't be scared, Bishop.
And one last thing, Doc. I was at a very low point. And this was in 2018. A lot of y'all didn't know. Doc knew. Not only did I have Doc in my corner to keep me afloat, because my health was really bad. I was really bad, Steve. You thought you was bad a couple months. I was like you. But I was still dragging myself to work because my wife is tough. So the deal is, God sent an advocate. Of all the people, he sent a former gang member of the Bloods. Yes. He was the only one that visited me in physical form to see if I was okay every day. Of course, Doc would call me, see if I was okay. But Jesus sent, of all people, a Blood. That, you got to talk to me about that when Amar died. Of all people, he sent a Blood to come see me every day.
Wow.
In a deep.
Eric Williams. Yeah, that's deep. And Doc, thank you, Bishop.
And Steven, I was on my way out too, bro, just like you, man. And then he know it. Diabetes ain't no joke. That's why I'm doing a movie about it.
No joke.
Ain't no joke.
Powerful, powerful. Wow. Almost in tears in your spirit, amen. Bishop, amen. Jerry, amen. Royce, amen. He used the analogy of artists such as Teddy Pendergrass and Sam Cooke, amen. Even when you feel like you're at your lowest, Jesus would send somebody. Eric Williams, he hit on this just a little, amen, when he talked about those atonements, amen, and the Lord was using him. I know he was, because he talked about the Leviticus, amen, that, you know, how Moses taught Brother Eric Williams, amen, if you allow me to kind of just tag on Jerry Royce in Leviticus 16 and 34, Moses taught this, Amen. Mm-hmm. Even when you feel at when you are at your lowest, thank you, Dr. Jerry Roy. See, we are real men nations. We're real men of God, amen. So when the sin, Moses was teaching, amen, this, when the sin of all of Israel was atoned for every year at the Day of Atonement, he was basically saying, Minister Eric Williams, not all of Israel was saved. Jerry Roy, is that what you're saying?
Amen.
Amen.
Everybody is saved, amen. But every now and then, see, Moses, he was kind of like a murderer on the run.
Mm-hmm.
Y'all have to go in your book, in other words, to understand that. He was a murderer on the run because he defended his brother, his Hebrew brother. In other words, he didn't like what they were doing, amen, to his brother.
Come on.
So he was running. But Jesus, oh, my God. God saw him on the backside of the desert and said, I can use him. I need you to go and talk to Dr. Jerry Royce. I need you to go and talk. Come on, somebody. Amen.
Yes,
to Paul Kelly. I need you to talk to Brother Ken Osborne and Kent Wiley and Trent Gatton.
Yes,
y'all know where the pastor's going on. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Dr. Jerry Royce, we got any music? Amen. Before we close out on this panel, we got any music from these artists, sir? We have to acknowledge, amen, and be obedient.
Yeah, go ahead and let the guys give everybody, you know, what they got. I know. Minister Williams got a big event going on tomorrow, so we want him to talk about that a little bit.
Hallelujah.
Then we can close out because we got the
Praise
next show
God.
Coming up. Amen.
Thank you, producer. Praise God. It's better to be obedient than to sacrifice. We always have to be obedient. Minister Eric Williams, would you thank you, sir, for sharing this powerful topic with us. Amen. Apostle John Ross, we thank you, sir, for your love and your spirit and your teaching, your theology. Minister Denny Jenkins, we thank you, spirit to spirit. Pastor Stephen Turner, stay where you at. Amen. Minister Eric Williams, share with us what you got coming up, sir.
I got a fundraising event for Guns Down Power Up. I'm collecting and gathering funds so I can pay the people that do this paperwork for me right. I don't want to do it half-stepping. I want things to be done and decent and in order. So I'm putting on a fundraiser in Opelousas, Louisiana. Man, it's going to be great. A Guns Down Power Up fundraiser. And the people are already sending donations. Thank God. Praise God. I'm very thankful and grateful for that. You know, people are already sowing seed.
I'm sorry. Do you have a link that we can go to, sir?
Yeah.
Amen.
I haven't put a link up on Facebook, but you can go to Guns Down Power Up. And I have a PayPal set up on Guns Down Power Up on my page. Or you can simply inbox me. You know, and I can send you an address, and you can send a love seed that way, however you feel comfortable, you know. And I'm very grateful and thankful for the people who are sowing seeds. Again, you can go on Guns Down Power Up, my Facebook page on Facebook, and you can find out all the information you need to know to send a love seed or, you know, whatever God lay on your heart. It'd be greatly appreciated.
Amen. Praise God. Thank you. Thank you. We thank you once again, Apostle John Ross. Amen. Let's talk to the Lord. Amen. Award-winning talk show host. Amen. Artist Denny Jenkins, spirit to spirit. Powerful words ministered to those out there. Amen. Who may have felt sometimes that they just don't feel like they're in the ark of safety after they've given themselves to Christ. Amen. And thank you, Jenkins, Mr. Jenkins, for those powerful words. Minister Eric Williams, gun down, power up. Amen. I like that chess analogy, sir. You're going to have to talk to us about that. Amen. Praise God. Pastor Stephen Turner, we thank each and every one of you. Amen. Pastor Stephen Turner, I want you to take us out. Just go ahead and lead us in prayer. Amen. And remember, nation, amen, 1 John 2:12-14, amen. I write to you, little children, because your sins are forgiven. Amen. And not only that, he went on to say, I write to you, fathers, because you have known him who is from the beginning. I write to you, young men, because you have overcome the wicked one. I write to you, little children, because you have known the Father. I write to you, fathers, because you have known him who is from the beginning. I write to you, saying, young men, because you are strong. Brothers, you are strong. Men, you are strong. Thank you for being with us tonight. Amen. Pastor Turner, take us out in prayer, sir.
All right, if we can all just bow our heads. Dear God, Elohim, Dad, and I.
Hallelujah. Yes, Lord,
we thank you for what you've done.
Glory.
For the spiritual platform that you provided, this international platform that you
thank you.
Speak to men. Yes, all nations and all tongues, all creeds and all colors. We thank you. So unless the word circles earth, then you become. We bless your name from the crown of our heads to the soles of our feet. We thank you for what you're doing. Thank you for your movement of your spirit. We thank you for the breaking down of your glorious word. And it says, my little children. And so if we are remain humble, remain forthright, if we need help, we're going to ask for it. Then the word applies to us. And even if any man sin, we have an advocate. There's someone that will talk for you. His name is Jesus Christ. And so you ought to get to know him. You ought to get to talk to him. You ought to get to revel in him and enjoy and exalt. And fall down on your knees wherever you may be and just ask God for the Holy Ghost, the moving of the blood of Jesus to cover you, that you want it, you need it, you've got to have it, you must have it tonight before dawn. You need it now, and so get in a hurry, get an emergency, like going to the ER. You're going to the spiritual ER to get your blessings, get your destiny. For you're living beneath your privilege. Good God Almighty, you need it.
Thank you, God.
And so we thank you. We thank you. Let every voice, let every heart say amen.
Yes. Amen. And amen. Thank you. Thank you, Pastor. Amen. And thank you for joining us in this powerful episode of Next Man Up. Stay tuned. Keep your dial right there for another powerful episode of award-winning Late Night with Jerry Royce Live and Anointing TV host. Amen. And radio host Paula G. Following that, let's go to the Midnight Church with the Christian Party Line with host artist Shay Sam. This is our time. We'll see you next week. Amen. Next Friday on Next Man Up. I am your host, Dr. Paul Kelly. God bless you and God bless this nation.
Humble, young man, humble. Woo! This is Jarrell Golden of Holy Ground Music Group, and you are listening to Jerry Royce Live, worldwide podcast in Charm City. A quick question. Can you feel the power?
All right, family, we want to thank everybody for tuning in to Next Man Up with Dr. Paul Kelly. That's right, on his testimony. All right, y'all, coming up next at 11:30. Well, actually, in a few minutes, going to be me and Paula G, the voice. We got a special guest. That's right, Mr. Chase going to be here. That's right, we're going to have a great time. So find out what's going on in the world, everybody. So tune in at 11:30. But you can hang in there with us right now. Paula's coming up. All right, also, at midnight, Shay Samuels is going to be leading the charge with the Christian Party Line with the ladies of radio. So hang in there with us, y'all. Going to 1 o'clock. It's all good, y'all. That's right. Jesus is our advocate. Ask and you shall receive. That's right. You need some help, y'all. Don't be begging. Just pray. Pray to him. Talk to him. You got to get intimate now. Get in that deep meditation. Focus. That's right. He's here for you. He probably spoke to you a long time ago. You just wasn't listening. He told you what to do. All right, y'all. Paula G's coming up. Let's talk to Paula G. What's up, Paula G, the voice?
Hey, Jerry Voice Live Worldwide. What's going on, my brother?
Worldwide, baby, worldwide.
Worldwide.
We all
That's
good.
Us. Yeah, worldwide. Yeah.